This meeting should have been an email.
Same line, same framing, but watch this.
This meeting should have been an email.
One word changed everything. That single shift turned a flat AI performance into something that seemed actually directed. And it made me ask the big question, can you actually direct AI like a real actor? So I ran a test. I took one image and one scripted line and generated 42 different emotional performances. And the results, honestly, they surprised me. Hey, if you're new here, I'm Gabe Michael. I'm a filmmaker and creative production executive, and I have over 20 years experience making films, videos, ads, and shows. You name it, I've made it. And now I'm exploring the future of entertainment with AI. As a director, I've spent years working with actors, helping them unlock specific emotional beats, find intention behind lines, and build performances from the inside out. So the question isn't just can AI act or can you direct AI like an actor? It's deeper than that. It's if you treat AI like a performer, will it listen? So to be clear, this experiment is about the can, not the should. I'm not saying we should replace actors or sideline the craft. I simply want to push the models to see what's possible when a director's mindset meets prompt-based filmmaking. As I was thinking of how to set up this experiment, one of the most overlooked tools in the director's toolbox came to mind, and it's called the emotion wheel. It's a tool that maps 8 primary emotions and shows how they can combine to create deeper, more nuanced emotional shades, helping to express feelings with greater specificity. As a director, I mostly use this during prep. When I'm looking at a script, I go line by line and write down 3 emotions that could shape how an actor plays the moment. Sometimes I even throw in one that doesn't make sense on page, just to give the actor another color to try. I do this so when I'm on set, I am prepped. And if an actor is struggling with the scene or just wants to try things a new way, I am ready to just come with some very specific words that they can take and run with. In traditional filmmaking, emotion lives in the prep, the rehearsal, in the direction, and then accumulates in the performance. In AI filmmaking, it ends directly in your output, through your language. It's about giving the model something to feel. The more specific you are, the better your results. Whether you're writing down a prompt, drawing out directions, or doing timestamp moments in VO3, whatever your method is, specificity gives you control. So for this emotional test with dialogue scene, I needed a model that could take video and audio and sync them together. And of course, at the time of this recording anyway, the only thing that does that is VO3. The setup was simple. I wrote one core piece of direction with a prompt, and that is with a blank tone and expression, the man on the right side of the frame says, "This meeting should have been an email." And the only thing I would change, take after take, is that single emotion word. And honestly, it kind of felt like I was on set again.
This meeting should have been an email.
Okay, now give it to me with remorse.
This meeting should have been an email.
All right, let's try a different direction. Let's try cheeky.
This meeting should have been an email.
And I did this 42 more times. Here's just a few of the results.
This meeting should have been an email. This meeting should have been an email. This meeting should have been an email.
Pretty incredible, right? You just change one word and the model knows the difference between those core emotions. And it also understands the difference between something that's pretty generic, like sad and disillusioned.
This meeting should have been an email. This meeting should have been an email.
And just that little tweak changes the performance. But of course, it wasn't all perfect. Sometimes AI just missed the mark.
This meeting should have been an email. This meeting should have been an email. This meeting should have been an email.
Of course, there is a much more powerful approach that keeps the human at the center of the performance. It's a method that I call performance-led generation. This is where you, the human, actually act out the scenes. Tools like Act 2 by Runway can capture your real movements, your facial performance, and then map them directly to an AI character. It's the most direct route to bring genuine human nuance into an AI-generated scene.
This meeting should have been an email.
I'm obviously not a great actor, but if you are, a tool like this, it doesn't replace you. It It hands you the director's chair. You can star in and shape your performance inside any world that you can imagine. So whether you're generating still images, directing AI characters, or working with real-life performances, one thing hasn't changed in filmmaking and in life. Your words matter. Specificity matters. Direction matters. Now it's your turn. All 42 emotionally driven clips, the original prompt, and the original source image are now live at creativepossible.com. Give it a try. I'd love to see your outputs. And if you find that useful, you should check out the cinematic AI prompt method or watch this video here. Until next time, I'm Gabe Michael. Be well, do good, and make awesome things.